which Ramadan and bless it for us and make us in it in the best state of iman and taqwa. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us Laylatul Qadr. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. So the Quran and Ramadan are very strong relation. Yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Shahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an. Ramadan is the month of Quran. And we started, inshallah, from today a new series. It's about the Quran. It's not tafsir, just the meaning, inshallah, highlights of some of the meaning of the Quran. And we start as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started in the Quran. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is the greatest surah of the Quran. Every one of us knows it. This is the greatest surah. It's greater than Al-Baqarah, Al-Imran, Al-Nisa. All this giant, big, long surah, Al-Fatiha is greater than all of them. For something special, Allah put it in. And that's easy for us to really understand because we repeat it every day, about 30 times. Every Muslim in the planet who pray, they pray 17 rak'ah minimums and 12 or 13 rak'ah sunnah. It's 30 times. Allah has asked us to repeat something 30 times. It would be really embarrassing to come to Allah not understanding Al-Fatiha. It's really, really sad state. If Allah asks us to repeat something 30 times, it's a hint. That is actually, you know, we need to understand what we say. So the Prophet was sitting with Jibreel, the best human being, sitting with the best angel. And Jibreel is a very good friend of the Prophet. They used to love each other so much that the Prophet used to ask Jibreel to come home. Please come and visit us. And he says, I only come when I'm alone. I only come when I get permission. I just can't come on my own accord. So Jibreel, when sitting with the Prophet ﷺ, heard a gate in the sky opens up. And he told the Prophet ﷺ that there is a gate in heaven, in the sky, opened up for the first time. And an angel coming down from it for the first time and the only time. This angel is just from one of those VIP angels, never come to earth. But he only come down to give me some good news. And this is the only time he comes, he will never come back again. He came to the Prophet ﷺ and said to him, As-salamu alaykum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you two nurs, two lights, two gifts, only for you. It was never ever revealed to the Bible, the Old Testament, to Moses, to Jesus, to Saul, nobody. Nobody have ever been given these two gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Fatiha wa akhatim Surah Al-Baqarah. And the last few ayahs of Surah Al-Baqarah. These are gifts for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for all of us. And for all of us. So this is the gift. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called Al-Fatiha al-Shafiyah. It's a cure. It's actually a cure for our sickness. Physical sickness, Al-Fatiha is a cure. Spiritual sickness, Al-Fatiha is a cure. We need to learn it, understand it, and repeat it. And whenever you have problems, aches, pain, sadness, Al-Fatiha wallahi. The Prophet ﷺ used it, and the Sahaba used it as a cure. It will relieve your difficulty. It will take your anxiety away. It will give you what you need. Surah Al-Fatiha is the first surah to be revealed as a whole. You know, the Quran has 114 surah. Can you imagine this with me? 114 surah. All of them revealed piecemeals, bits and bits. You know, a few eyes here, a few eyes there. Over 23 years. And every surah has different builds. Every surah has so many different ayahs. And every ayah has ruling. And the Prophet Muhammad doesn't read or write. And he will have 50, 60 people, genius, who can read and write. And he will tell them, put this ayah in this surah, put this ayah in this surah, put this ayah in this surah. What kind of brain is this? No human being can do this. No human being. It's not a human humanly possible to have in your head 114 different projects, and every project have hundreds of different instructions, and it's all in your head, and you have all those teams, and you know Which ayah goes where? It's incredible. Surah Al-Fatiha was revealed as a whole. It was revealed as seven ayah just came together. Before the Al-Fatiha, we know, Iqra, some of it came down. Ya ayyuhal Muddathir, some of it came down. Ya ayyuhal Muzammil, some of it came down. And Noon wal Qalam wal Mastur. Only this four surah was before Al-Fatiha. Not the four surah, some of it. So Al-Fatiha came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a whole. And Al-Fatiha is the first surah, and maybe the only surah that teaching us how to talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How to call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is, what the scholars say, it's the summary of all Islam. It's the summary of the whole Qur'an, it's in that Al-Fatiha, the introduction to the Qur'an. Is in what they call today the executive summary. You know what's in the Qur'an? You will find it in Al-Fatiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it, لَقَدْ أَتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. Allah calls it the Great Qur'an. Allah called Al-Fatiha the Great Qur'an. Allah actually called the Salah we do Al-Fatiha. Or Al-Fatiha is the Salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah says, فَسَلْتُ الصَّلَاةِ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصْفَانِ. The Salah is shared 50-50, half for my servant and half for me. Allah, the creator of the universe, saying that. We need to really concentrate on this one, because our salah, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, imaduddin, it is the biggest foundation for the whole religion. Man aqamaha, whoever established a good foundation, faqad aqama ad-din. The whole religion is established well. وَمَنْ هَدَمَهَا, whoever doesn't care about the salah, foundation is crumbling, the whole religion is crumbling. One more scary part, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make alcohol haram for the Arab at the beginning, because it will confuse them in salah. Allah says, لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارَى. Allah says, don't go near salah, don't pray while you're drunk. Because alcohol was not haram at the beginning. Why? حَتَّى تَعْلَمُوا مَا تَقُولُونَ. So you know what you're saying. So when you're standing in salah, you know, you say, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greater. Allah is greater than my problem. I can't be in salah, and all what I'm thinking about, when is the man going to finish? Especially Tarawih is coming next week. That is really scary. It's really scary. We need to really get every possible reason to concentrate in salah. Because shaitan, this is a special shaitan for salah. A special shaitan come to steal the salah away from us. So, Allah says, I've divided the salah between me and my servant in half. Listen to this. فَإِذَا قَالَ عَبْدُ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. You're standing up and say, الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah Himself responds with every ayah. And that's another wisdom why we stop at the ayah. The Prophet ﷺ used to say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. He stopped. He doesn't say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, Ya Rahim, Ya Rahim, Ya Rahim. But finished. All of us, 2 minutes, finished. Some of us less than 2 minutes. 2 minutes is 2 minutes is extravagant. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen to the ayah. You say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah will say, Hamadani Abdi, my servant praised me. Wallahi, is incredible. Wallah is amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at you face to face and He says, my servant is praising me. Hamadani abdi, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah says, athna alayya abdi. My servant is glorifying me. My servant is making too much mention of me. Maliki yawm al-deen, majjadani abdi. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een. My servant, this is between me and my servant, because it's half. Oh Allah, you are only worship. So we worship Allah, and when you are in this time, you are only asked for help. Allah says, this is between me and between my servant. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. All this is a dua. Allah says, that's for my servant, and for my servant, whatever you ask for. Every single time we stand and read Al-Fatiha, Allah is talking to us. Allah is talking to every one of us. Allah is listening to every word we say. That's why Al-Fatiha is the greatest surah of the whole Quran. That's why Al-Fatiha is the greatest surah of the whole Quran. And as you know, the Prophet ﷺ said that this surah is the greatest surah. It was not nothing like Al-Fatiha was revealed in the Old Testament, the Bible, the Torah, whatever it is. Allah chose this ummah, chose all of us to receive this surah, which is the greatest surah of the whole Quran. Every one of us knows it. Now it's every one of us, inshallah, to learn the meaning of Al-Fatiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبْعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِي وَالْقُرْآنِ الْعَظِيمِ. Seven ayahs, very short. Mathani. The Mathani translated to three things. Seven ayahs. They're not seven verses. They're ayahs. Verses is English word is not equal to ayah. Ayah is a sign. Sign to Allah's power. Sign to the Quran. Sign to the greatness of the book Allah has chosen us to receive. Sab'an al-Mathani. The seven ayah glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a thana, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seven ayah means also the most repeated ayah. We repeat that we say 30 times every day. 30 times every day we say Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. It begins by, of course, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today, inshallah, we'll try to talk about Al-Basmala. Al-Basmala. Al-Basmala is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the Ba, the first letter in the Quran, subhanAllah. The scholars give time even on the first letter in the Quran. The Ba, they call it Ba al-Istihana wa Ba al-Musahaba. You say in Arabic Ba, you need help. By, you know, using Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name to help you. Ya Allah, I need your help. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu is saying, before you begin anything, he said, Bismillah. Bismillah before you go to bed. Bismillah when you wake up. Bismillah before you eat. Bismillah when you put the clothes on. Bismillah before when you take the clothes off. He said, Bismillah. It's a protection for us. So the first thing, you ask Allah to protect you. You ask Allah to help you. You ask Allah to be by your side. You ask Allah to support you. This is bad. Bab al-Isti'ana. You're asking Allah to help you by using His powerful name. The other one is Bab al-Musahaba. You're asking Allah's blessing. You want Allah to bless your work. You want Allah to, because you're starting, you say, Bismillah, I'm going to do my study. Bismillah, I'm going to do my work. Bismillah, I'm going to drive now. How many people drive and never ever return back home? How many people going to work and it was the last day at work? How many people going out? Yeah, so many every day it happened in front of us. So the Muslim is seeking Allah and calling in Allah's name, Ya Allah, I'm a slave, I need your help. I'm trying to please you, please bless me and bless my work. Put barakah in it, put blessing in it. So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim also, it's kind of, the scholar saying, you need to have a three dots after it. Because what does it mean in English when you say, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most kind? You know, it's really, there is no, there's still not enough meaning yet for the listener. If you talk to somebody who's not Muslim, and he's in the name of Allah, the most merciful, most kind, you're going to continue. What are you doing? So, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, they call it a statement. It doesn't have a verb in it. There's no action in it yet. It's waiting for you to do the verb. So, in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most kind, I will study. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most kind, I'm going to eat. In the name of Allah, I'm driving. So this statement, it has the blank afterward for you to fill in. Everything you're going to begin, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, I will begin my action. Yeah, you got the idea? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given it to us. For us to fill the blank. And that's what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that anything that doesn't begin with Bismillah, it is not blessed. فَهُوَ أَقْطَعْ. It is not blessed without the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Also, in the name of Allah, only say Bismillah. Because if you say, I'm eating, Bismillah, you put the verb first,
Then you can say, I eat in the name of Allah and the name of Allah and the name, yeah? As the other religions say. In Qur'an, in this ayah, Basmala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his name first. It means only in the name of Allah I begin. It's also tawheed. It's also tawakkul. I put my trust only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless the action I'm trying to do. So what did we say? Bismillah for two things. Al-Ista'ana and Al-Musahaba. He's seeking Allah's help and he's seeking Allah's blessing. In anything you do, as Muslim, before going to bed, we say Bismillah. The Prophet ﷺ said, even before going to toilet, he said, Bismillah, A'udhu billahi min kufr al-khabar. That's a protection. The Prophet ﷺ said, before you take the clothes off, you say, Bismillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cover you, will protect you. Before driving, before studying, before working. Yeah? So this is the instruction of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ for us to seek Allah's help and seek Allah's blessing in everything we do. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is like a dua. It's like a dua we do every single time we begin something. It's like a dua asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless the action we are doing. Bismillah. It is something that should be part of our life. It's not just a lip read or tongue. It's from our heart. Ya Allah, I'm seeking your help. Ya Allah, I'm seeking you. Please, bless the action. Bless the study. How many times you spend looking at the paper and studying and say, I don't get it. I just don't get it. Because yeah, you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open it up for you. Because it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who says in the Quran, فَفَحْنَاهَا سُلَيْمَانَ. We made Sulaiman understood it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ar-Rahman, عَلَّمَ الْقُرَانَ. It's the one who teach you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us. So when you say Bismillah before something, you cannot be just saying it because you memorize it. No, you're saying because you actually need Allah's help and you need Allah's blessing. You need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be by your side. And as we say, it's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all what they taught us in the young age, in the name of Pakistan, in the name of the people, in the name of the public, in the name of, yeah? No, as a Muslim, only in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It teaches ikhlas. It teaches tawheed. It teaches sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot be starting something and say, Bismillah, in the name of Allah, I need your help. I need your blessing while you're showing off. Allah, it might look like through your heart and all what you're doing is actually fake. So that help us that whatever we do, we say, Bismillah, I'm doing it for Allah's pleasure. I'm doing it to have Allah's blessing in it. I'm doing it seeking Allah's help. You cannot have another intention in your heart for anything else. So Bismillah repeatedly teaching us ikhlas. He teaches us trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, teaching us tawheed. The Prophet said even about physical nourishment, eating. It's not a religious act. Eating is nothing about, you know, it's not ritual. But the Prophet said, even in that, even for the little children, he says, Ya ghulam, sambillah. Young boy, say Bismillah. If it was not serious, the Prophet would not have given that instruction. It is so serious that even that nourishment, physical or spiritual, it needs Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing in it. The Prophet, when he used to be sick, he used to say Bismillah on the pain. He used to put his hand where the pain is and say Bismillah. That's it, just Bismillah. Bismillah, Bismillah. But it's not just words. He's saying what? He's saying, I need your Allah, I need your help. I need your blessing. I need your help. Ya Allah, please help me out. I seek your help. And when you say Allah, you're actually calling with all Allah's powerful attributes. When we say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gives cure, the one who gives help, the one who gives power, the one who gives safety, the one who, it's included in the name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, when he goes down to bed, he says, Bismillahi wa ta'ala jambi wa bikafa. It's the name of Allah. He says the same thing, Bismillah, when he goes down, sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. And he used to say, Bismillah, الَّذِي لَا يَضُرُّ مَعَ اسْمِهِ شَيْءٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. And he started with the name of Allah. I'm calling on the name of Allah, that nothing will harm me. Nothing will harm you if you mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he goes out of the house, what does he say?
Bismillah,
I put my trust in Allah. So the first part is Bismillah, which is seeking Allah's help and seeking Allah's blessing. Ya Allah, help me. Ya Allah, bless me. Ya Allah, put barakah. Ya Allah, make it good. Make it successful. Make whatever I deem good for me and good for my family and good for the community. And Bismillah. And Bismillah is mentioning Allah. Dhikr. It is dhikr, isn't it? And the Prophet said, سبق المفردون. The winners, the true winners that gone ahead of everybody, مفردون. They ask the Prophet, who are مفردون? He says, الذاكرون الله كثيرا. Those remember Allah much. Male or female, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, whatever you do, how easy it is to say, Bismillah. Bismillah before you start writing. Bismillah before you start reading. Bismillah when you're driving. Yeah, when you're going in, Bismillah is very powerful. And that's why the Qur'an begins with it. It is the beginning of the Qur'an. It is the first step in getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah, it's seeking Allah's blessing and seeking Allah's help. From the, subhanAllah, the ba, only this is the ba we're talking about. Just saying the ba of Bismillah, the first letter in the Qur'an, it calls on Allah's help and it calls on Allah's blessing for everything we do. Because who else will be the source of blessing? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah? Tabaraka. Yeah? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Also, because we mention Allah, we know that Allah is watching. If you mention Allah, you will not be doing something wrong after it. It develops in us ihsan. It develops inside us doing the best we can by mentioning Bismillah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim also fills us with hope because we are already in the blessing and the seeking of help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it gets Allah's involved. Yeah? You get Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala involved in action you do. Just saying Bismillah, you know as a Muslim that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is on your side. So whatever wudu, the Prophet used to say Bismillah. We do things only in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This also a purification from shirk. It cleans and clears our intention from doing things in any other reason. We're doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Then, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So when you say Bismillah, you can put any attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after. In the name of Allah, the most powerful. In the name of Allah, the most wise. In the name of Allah, the all-rich. Yeah? In the name of, there's so many attributes of Allah. The most beautiful attributes belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran telling us to use special attributes. Which one? Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The first attributes of Allah, the first description of Allah that He introduced Himself to us is Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's, of course, we all know there is no single letters in Quran without absolutely the wisdom and the purpose for its place. So for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to begin the Quran by Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is for all of us to reflect on. Allah wants to be known as Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Because Allah could have said, you know, the most knowledgeable, could have said the all-knowing, could have said the all-powerful. He has all the names, the beautiful names. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose this name for us? The name that we repeat every day. Many tens of times every single day we say Allah is the most kind, is the most caring, is the most merciful.
Sorry for all the technical issues with the sound. The lens is coming back. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. When we say before we go to Rahman. So we say Bismillah, the Ba, it's about seeking Allah's help, seeking Allah's blessing. When you mention Allah, in the name of Allah, Allah is the entity, is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has all the attributes. You say Allah Rahman, Allah Al-Ghani, Allah Al-Qawi, yeah? Allah is the most powerful. You don't say the other way around. You don't say Al-Qawi, Allah Rahman, Allah. It's the Allah Rahman Al-Rahim. So when you say Bismillah, you call in Allah's attributes, all of it, to be with you. You need Allah's strength, you need Allah's wisdom, you need Allah's support. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, you need to be Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants us to have these behaviors. He wants us to have this attribute, to be generous and kind and caring for each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةً أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ. You were created, you were brought out, not for yourself. You were created to save mankind. To save mankind, to guide mankind, to be an example. So people look at you and says, wallahi, this is the best religion. This must be the truth. I need to listen, learn about it. I need to find out more. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose these names for us to reflect on. And Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, you can't translate really. It's really difficult to translate in English. But simply, Ar-Rahman is a general. Ar-Rahman is general mercy and care and love from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the universe, not only the human being. Allah in the Quran always mentioned the universe and mentioned Ar-Rahman. So Ar-Rahman is the one who sent the rain. And the rain doesn't have difference or distinguish between Muslim and non-Muslim. Ar-Rahman is the one that created the sun, the stars, the air, the universe, the rivers, the ocean, Ar-Rahman. So that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His mercy and care and love for everyone, for everything. But Ar-Rahim, you will find it always come to the believers. It's a specific. وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا, Allah says. Rahim, it belongs to the specific and special to those who believe in Him. Some scholars say Ar-Rahman, it is attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It describes who Allah is. He is the one that is full of mercy and full of love and full of care. You can't imagine Allah's love and care and mercy. You can't imagine it. But Ar-Rahim, it is His action. His action also are full of love and care and mercy. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent His best human being, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to struggle for 23 years to save human being, to serve human being, to guide human being. So Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you say, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman, which means intense and vast love and care. Anything in Arabic, it has an at the end, it means overflowing with rahman. Overflowing. So when you say Rahman, it's like Ramadan. Ramadan is full of heat. That's what the month is. Jaw'an is full of hunger. Ghadban is full of anger. So this pattern in Arabic, so when you say Rahman, it's His Rahmah, His love, His care is overflowing. You can't imagine it, you can't limit it. You can't limit it, you can't give up on it. You can't say, oh, I've done so much bad, I can't be hoping in Allah. No. Hitler could have hope in Allah's Rahmah. Fir'aun, which is worse than Hitler, also had hope in Allah's Rahmah. So don't ever, because we say Bismillah Rahman Rahim, no matter what sin you've done, the Prophet ﷺ said, even if you come with the whole earth full of sin, and you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in Him alone, He will come with rahmah and forgiveness enough to cover all your sins. So that is the attributes that we need to know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rahmah, it is not limited. It is absolutely will cover everyone and everything. First line in the Quran. It's the first line in the Quran that says Allah is the one who will give you, He will forgive you, He will guide you, He will help you, He will support you. He is the one that you call in every single rak'ah, we say, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Ar-Rahim, it's about Allah's action. That He will always, always, always have love and care and mercy. It will never stop. It will never stop. So inshallah, just summarize. We said Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim only today. Inshallah, next week we'll do Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The Ba is seeking Allah's blessing and seeking Allah's help. And he's saying Bismillah in the name of Allah, Allah's attributes, you call it on Allah's attributes to help you. So if you're sick, if you're in pain, if you're sad, if you're angry, if you're afraid, whatever you need, you say Bismillah. 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 Just that's more than enough. Bismillah. Bismillah. And then you have all the hope and love and mercy and care from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rahman. And then Ar-Rahim, it will never stop. It will never stop. One day the Prophet ﷺ was praying and somebody from the desert just came to join the Sahaba, just became a new Muslim. And he was standing in the Saf, a person sneezed in Salah. Somebody sneezed and that Arabi, person from the desert, he started to talk to that person who sneezed, Alhamdulillah, God bless you. So and the person doesn't reply. And he keeps repeating to him, Alhamdulillah, he wasn't going to hadikum Allah or something. So the Sahabi who knows doesn't talk in Salah. And the man keeps talking. And the Sahaba want him to speak, so they bang on their thigh like this. They want him to stop, so they bang on their thigh. Once they say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum, they want to strangle him. He says, why are you talking to us? Let Allah. The Prophet called him over, he sat him, wrapped his arm around him, and he said to him, in Salah, we don't talk. In the Salah, we don't talk. That's all. He did not tell him anything. He just told him, yeah? The man raised his hand and he asked Allah, Ya Allah, please have mercy on me and Muhammad alone. Don't hold this power. The Prophet ﷺ said to him, what? He says, Ar-Rahman is so vast. It's so vast, you can't narrow it to 2 people. You can't narrow it to 2 billion people. You can't narrow it to only the Arab. No. It covers everything. The Prophet ﷺ said, from Allah's rahmah, one of his rahmah is that when the animals give birth, they lift their feet away from the babies just being born. You know, they don't. Because imagine if a horse stood in just born, or the camel, or the elephant. So it's rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire all these animals even to gently lift the feet away from the baby, from just newborn baby. This is the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's our religion. Subhanallah, this is our religion. It's a religion of love and care and mercy and rahmah. It's a religion of seeking Allah's blessing. It's a religion of helping others. It's a religion of beginning everything by seeking Allah to make us do it in the best way possible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make what we say and what we hear and our efforts pleasing to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our efforts. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people of Quran. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our knowledge in the Quran. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easier for us to understand and to learn the Quran. And may Rabbil Alameen, Jazakumullah.